identify themselves as indie makers, but actually they should be involved in the community because there is a lot of similarities and they are eventually indie makers, even if they don't feel like it yet. You mentioned something very interesting, which is the importance of marketing and launching. And you've been helping other indie makers launching their own project. So you mentioned Product Hunt, but also all the tools like Indie Hacker. So what are the things that you have to do to have a successful launch for your indie maker project or your micro startup? Is there a secret formula or something that you need to have on your to-do list before launching?
Yeah, so we can so a lot of people kind of like you know, they want to be perfectionists or they want to make everything so perfect and polished and solid.
Yes.
But I think in this reality of life, you know, we are humans, so we make mistakes, we have bugs, sometimes we have to refine money, sometimes we have issues with some dispute with people and some kind of dealing, you know, these things tend to happen, you know, something is not perfect in the world. So what we should be focusing on is the idea that we really want to build. And if we have that idea, we just kind of like stick to it and then kind of like just build it and then get feedbacks. And after you get feedbacks and you will have like 100 over opinions and views from other people, and you kind of get like really confused, you know, in the state whereby like, should I do it or not? Should I not do it? Should I polish this? Should I make this better? Should I add in more feature? Should I charge the price higher or lower or just like so-so, okay, you know? So all these conflicting thoughts and this kind of like make you confused and making you difficult is the kind of mentality that you should be understand. So a lot of people, if they want to start a project, make a list, okay, like a simple to-do list, like a piece of paper and a pencil and a pen, and work closely and get advice with the people who have done successfully. So that's rule number one, okay? Look up to the people who have done successfully. Secondly, you know, ask advice to the right people who have the knowledge in the particular set of problems that you are facing that you want to solve. And thirdly, a very important thing is the support community. Support community give you a lot of good vibes. It's really important because sometimes you feel stuck at what you do and you can't really share this to your family or your friends. You know what I mean? And people will probably say, "Huh, it's okay, you're not going to do this. You know, probably you can do it better." You know, this is the kind of advice we don't want to hear. Even though it sounds positive, like your friends will probably say, "Don't worry, bro," or "Don't worry, sis," or "Okay, you would do great, you know, don't worry." Mm-hmm. I mean, this is just encouraging words, but thank you. But I'm talking about solving technicality problems, like something that's really difficult and has been bothering your mind. So I think it's really important to go to the right people and find sources that actually could help you. So that's the whole picture in the beginning stage. And then you kind of like just want to build from the idea to the MVP. So MVP works really not simple, but something that you don't want to have similar ideas with other people in the market. But of course, you don't want to build something so different and it takes longer time. So you want to build something within the time that you have, and you just kind of build it. And then once you're done with what you did, and you know, most importantly, start monetizing at the early stage. So a lot of people, they don't understand why you know, monetization is important for them, because a lot of people, they think that monetization is not important because they think that, oh, monetization, I'll do this later, I want to grow followers first or users first, I want to launch an alpha or I want to launch a beta version and then get users. So for me, you got to finalize your pricing. But of course, it's a way of getting users getting on your platform. So this, what I can say is using those medium platforms like newsletters, and you can reach out to other people to share about your product, and you can get, you can invite people, like send invitation to people to the website or the app so that people can join. You know, the first 5 people who join or install or download your app or go to your website is the most important. You know, don't focus on like your first 100, your first 200. Now, a lot of people, they want to go for big numbers. But when I started a lot of my projects, also as well as community, or the products that I'm selling, you know, I always focus on this, like, first 3 or 5 people. So it's very important, because these are the first few people who actually believe in your product, they believe in your vision and your mission. So after that, you will need to prepare for the, like, soft launch, or whether like a different kind of launches. So you can have a varieties of launches. Like, you know, you can have a different concept, like launching with a different kind of theme, like maybe like a holiday theme or a cultural theme, like based on the calendar, you know. And you can have like soft launch kind of theme, and then and last but not least, which is the official launch. So what you should do for your official launch, I think the most important thing is you are ready to make business. It's like opening a shop. So you must be prepared for customer service, chat support, emails, getting refunded. Your terms and conditions must be right. Your privacy policy must be right. I think these are the important things, apart from just polishing your products. I'm pretty sure if your skills are good in web development or creating an app or like designing, I'm pretty sure your product will be great. But of course, people will always say, like, you know, I have to make it polished. I need to over-engineer this. Or like, I have to really work on it until it's polished. But sometimes people don't really care. So you just do it and just ship it and just launch it, okay? Once you launched it, you can now see what people are responding, you know? And then you kind of just get those comments, feedbacks, emails, response, or probably calls or even video calls. So I think one of these tips that I can share is nothing secret, honestly. There's no secret to this. It's just that getting the right audience. So if you're building like a tool, so you got to find the audience for people who likes to install the tools. Like if you want to build for people, like for like consumer kind, like user kind, who wants to use for something, then you can market for that kind of audience. So you have to see your audience and then go to the right social media platforms, okay? So to do that, as for me, I use Twitter, and I find that Twitter is full of words, right?
Yes.
So sometimes it kind of like, you know, reading all day, like every time you scroll up, it's words and words. Even on like Product Hunt, it's like words and product, words and just images. So I found this kind of like a way of kind of like make it very interactive. I just want to take like 30 seconds of your time, and I make a 30-second video and says about the product. So I will go like something like introducing your company logo or your product name, and then it goes like, this is how it works. Like, it helps to solve this problem. And then we have blah, 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 like 1,000 over sort of like things. And then sooner or later, for more, sign up now. Or probably, and then you just share it on Twitter or Facebook or whatever it is that you are on the social media platform. But not to forget, pick 3 winners probably is a way of marketing. Pick 3 winners and some giveaway license or like giveaway product, physical product, those who retweet or click like randomly. You know, it's very important to, you know, have some fun in your business when you launch. You don't want to stress out, because launching, people always look for votes or like likes button or like love. I don't know why, but we should focus on the leads as well. So
yeah.
If you're not getting leads, like probably you're only getting like 5 or 10, just be grateful. I think it's very important. Okay, I've done with 5 sales, that's it, I'm happy. But then how do you actually grow from 5 sales? So from the launch that you did, you can actually share the link that we have launched this, you know, a week ago or a month ago. So you can share, not by spamming, so don't do spamming, but share quality posting or news about your company that is growing. And don't be too quickly, keep already adding on the features, because that will actually you know, change the way how people think about your product. So what you can do is just write a story. So people love story. So story, like for example, you can create a blog or something, talk about how you actually built the product, you know, and then share the article with people. And if they're interested, you can actually buy this product or purchase this license or this software or this app, so on and so forth. So this is pretty much a few examples. And last but not least, I want to share is to build a community.
Yes.
Why is it so important? Because community will amplify or boost the voice, the volume. It's like right now, you can hear me, right? At the volume of 70, probably. But now with community, it will increase 100 or probably like 200. I don't know how, but you can do that. But just choose the right kind of platform that you want to grow your community. Is either you want to build a forum, whether you want to build a discourse, whether you want to build Discord, whether you are on Telegram or WhatsApp or whatever it is. But make sure that it have this engagement. Engagement is so important. And to do engagement, you want to be as human as possible. You don't want to approach like you are selling something. You know, you want to keep on selling and selling and selling, because, you know, if you keep on saying like you want to sell, people will just run away. People won't join the community. It needs to have engagement. Engagement about your product, how it actually helps, and actually it's solving your day-to-day basis stuff, you know. Or some people, they just want to use your product because they want to, you know, they want to be part of the community because they are your fan. You know, you got to make that fan level. So it's very important to have community, because community will give you one of the best feedback as well. So that's what I can share a bit more about, like a product launching here and there. And there's a lot of articles out there, but I recommend for those who want to start, they can try to do anything that is digital product and try to launch on Product Hunt, like probably every 1 month, if that's okay. But some people are quite hardcore. They kind of just ship every 2 weeks. I've seen people also launch in 1 year, I think more than like 50 over projects. It's kind of, it depends on your skill and depends on your time and also the ideas that you have.
It is very inspiring. I mean,